Withering Waves.
The thing that's been on my mind, kind of like how Kendrick and Drake on everyone's mind these days. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel, where I make content about the games that I like. And today, there's going to be a new game that I'm going to talk about, Withering Waves.
I'm about to bomb this whole motherfucking plane.
Now, if you hadn't heard of Withering Waves, you probably live under a rock, or you just don't care about gacha game, which is fine, you know, considering that there are better games out there, like League of Legends. Anyway, Withering Waves, post-apocalyptic, futuristic kind of setting. So basically, the rundown of the game is a big bad happened and almost destroyed all of humanity to the point of extinction. You know, horrible stuff, very bad stuff. Then the humans were able to cope with the big bad. Wow. Then you, the player, you get blasted from straight what I would literally call the abyss into the world, and you quite literally don't know where the fuck you came from, and you don't know anything, and you have to go to all the nations and help everyone that you meet and become a slave so that you can get answers and yabba dabba. Now, the first time I heard about Withering Waves was from a video from Tekton, shout out to Tekton, called Genshin Clone, but it's actually good. I think that's the name of the video. And in the video, he just reacts to a bunch of gameplay of the game.
Ready to jack their fucking
And I watched the whole video, and I gotta say, after that video, I was hooked. And I just kept up with the dev notes, the showcases, you know, all that stuff. And I just love the overall direction and like the amount of work and love that's put into the game. So now that you know what the game is about, I'm gonna tell you why I wanna play it so bad. It's one simple answer. Animated immersive combat. That's what I meant to say. One of the things I love about the games that I've played in the past is the very addictive combat that it has. To give examples, God of War with the Blades of Chaos, you know, in all the God of War games. Can't go wrong with that. You have World of Warcraft playing as a warrior and you're just swinging your fucking axe at everyone and you're just killing everything. League of Legends, when you're playing as Yasuo. I mean, I'm a Yasuo main, unfortunately. You know, you're just dashing around and you're stabbing everyone until you go 0 and 10 and everyone reports you and tells you to kill yourself. Withering Waves has all these qualities, and you know, why wouldn't I play it if it has those qualities? As someone that's trying to look for an escape on the hold that League of Legends has on me, I need this game so bad. Now, obviously, it goes to show that nothing is perfect. So obviously, there are some bad things about the game that I'm gonna talk about, but we'll leave that for later. The characters in this game, holy shit. They look so fucking hot, bro. They look so good. Oh my god, they look so good. We've entered Coomer territory. We've entered Coomer degeneracy. Because if there's one thing that most gacha games do properly, is character design. It doesn't matter how fucking bad the game is. Doesn't matter how bad the combat is. So long as there's hot fucking characters in the game, I'm telling you, there's gonna be people that are gonna play the fucking game. Me personally, I'm not one of those people. But it is an added bonus, so I'll take it without complaining. And one of the characters that I really like in this game, and I'm definitely going to go for immediately as soon as I can, is Calcharo or Kakarot. Me personally, I call him Kakarot because it's just 10 times cooler than Calcharo. I don't care what you say, fight me. Calcharo, really cool, big sword, Sephiroth, you can't go wrong with that. Fucking sexy dude, love that guy. Another character that I like, that's the same element, you already know, your girl Yinlin. I mean, just look at that body, man. No words needed. She's looking like a fucking snack with a six pack, making me act like a rat, looking for some Tic Tac. Hold on, I'm cooking here. Anyway, I just really love the game's character design. I love all the characters, except for Verena. I don't like that bitch. I don't like you. This is gonna be a hot take, and a lot of people are going to disagree with me on this, and I might be tripping, but the ecosystem, trash, fucking dog shit. I hate, I, there's no way you're gonna catch me going all the way from Africa to fucking China just so that I can get an artifact with doo-doo fucking stats. I'm not fucking doing that, bro. Now, to be fair, they did say that they were gonna fix that shit. They said they were gonna make it easier. They were gonna make the substats, you know, all that shit. They said they were gonna fix it. So I can only give a proper opinion once I play the game and see how it is. But as of right now, that ecosystem is trash. I'm sorry. That's just how it is. Fuck you. I don't care what you think. Another thing I don't like, and this is a little bit niche, the gliding speed. I'm telling you on my life, if a turtle, that fucking turtle, that tacit Discord turtle, whatever the fuck that shit is, if that turtle and you were in a race and you were fucking gliding, I'm telling you, that turtle will die of old age before you reach the fucking finish line. It's not fast enough. At least make it fast to the point where it feels like a form of transportation. And it's not just like, you get what I, like I don't know, man.
Hey, fuck this shit, I'm jerking off.
Now, one of the things that I try to do, but I'm not that good at, is trying to involve myself in new communities. Because, you know, it's good to make new friends, you know, have new experiences, new connections, stuff like that, you know. But the problem for me is that I'm a League and Genshin player that used to think that when your balls get cut off, you can't pee anymore. So I probably can't make any fucking friends. So that's probably it. Having a good connection with the communities that you're in, it really makes the game feel more grounded, if that makes any sense. The Within Rift community, to me at least, feels very genuine. There's a lot of cool people in there. I don't think I've had any interaction with anyone that was like, oh, this guy's a weirdo. Well, not yet. There's always some bad apples out there, you know, can't avoid that. I also just want to broaden my horizons. I just don't want to cover just one game on my channel. I just don't want to cover League. I want to cover other games too. And, you know, because I live in Nigeria, a lot of games that would be possible for any of you to play, I can't fucking do that. Because one, the net over here is fucking dog shit. So it's probably gonna take me like 2 days to download Withering Waves when it does come out. Two, the power is also dog shit. Because sometimes the power goes out randomly. And guess what? I can't do anything about it. So I can't even play for long periods of time, even if I wanted to, or even stream for that matter. I can't fucking do that. So yeah, it fucking sucks. And God knows that I'm not fucking covering Genshin Impact on my channel. All right, well, we've come to the end of the video. I hope you like listening to me talk about this game that I like so much. Hopefully you had a good time. For my subscribers, I would say thank you so much for all the support that you've given me throughout this entire time. It's been a real experience. I want to experience more. I want to make more friends. I want to build a bigger community, you know, stuff like that. And to the new viewers that are here, consider subscribing, leave a like, comment how you felt about this video, about how you feel about Withering Waves. Obviously, I'm always playing League because I'm fucking addicted. So if you play League too, you can join the Discord. We play a lot of League. Can't wait for the game to come out May 22nd. I implore all of you to at least try it out, because I'm going to be covering a lot of Withering Waves, and I mean a lot. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I will catch you on the next one. Stay juicy, stay safe, and I'll see you later. Bye. Subscribe or I'll find you.